They don't make music like that anymore. On the black culture as a whole. You guys have been requesting for quite some time now. Before we get started, make sure you smash that like button, smash that subscribe button, do every button, you know, that can help the system out. And let's get started. Now, let me just start off by saying that essentially, in the beginning, this was supposed to be a history of hip hop and rap type of video. However, when I started to delve in and look into it, I realized, along with a lot of stuff that we do and have come up with and have created, there's no 100% clear and concrete answer as to who created hip hop and rap in terms of who the real legit founding fathers are. I had to watch documentary on documentary, read articles upon articles, and I just got a headache. But of course, with a lot of the things that we do, it's not tracked properly, and then there's numerous theories mixed with a whole bunch of whitewashing and a whole bunch of degradation and throwing jabs at each other. So if you're like me, you most likely thought that hip-hop and rap culture started in New York and it was heavily and is heavily influenced by the Jamaican culture of dancehall music and toasting. And essentially, what I've always heard and exactly what I saw when I first started researching is that a lot of DJs in New York would play music and what we would call now instrumentals. While they would play these beats, they would go and put words of like other popular songs on top of the beat and people would just rock out. Like they would have these really, really great parties. Like, listen, I think I was born in the wrong time because I'm like, yo, I was trying to be at these parties. I was trying to get down, you feel me? I'm sorry, something wrong with me. Eventually, these parties were so dope, so great, and of course, were so innovative and creative, people started to rap over them. And these people became MCs and now what we call rappers. Now, what's very interesting is the word DJ and the word MC essentially comes from Jamaica. Jamaicans were doing this first. The dance hall, the toasting, the MCing, most of that comes from Jamaica. I really always thought this specifically, not only because it's something I grew up knowing and that's what I've been told, but when I got to college and I took Caribbean literature, we would literally go through the music, the poetry, and a lot of the other cultural and artistic aspects of the Caribbean. And dance hall was one of the things we focused on for the longest because the history of dance hall is just so rich, so long. There's a lot going on there. I'll never forget, every time I would raise my hand to answer a question, I'm like, oh, the dance hall, the rap me, and she'd be like, the dance hall. I'm like, for me, it's always sounded like rap. Like if you guys go hear old dance hall, like legit dance hall, it sounds exactly the same to rap music. It's insane. But upon really looking deeper, I realized that a lot of people do not agree with this theory at all. And a lot of people will jump down your throat if you try to say that this is the truth. Of course, we have the whole theory of African Bambaataa being the founding father and the only founding father. And people on his neck of the woods are always like, oh, you know, well, the Bronx did it first. Meanwhile, there's the whole feud of, well, DJ Herc in Brooklyn did it first. There's that whole feud right there. And I don't want to get into the whole African Bambaataa thing because he does not have a very good past, okay? There's a lot of upsetting and disturbing things that we're not going to get into today. You guys can look into them yourselves that I just don't want to talk about it. But essentially, they try to say that DJ Herc and everyone else on his neck of the woods basically stole that whole ideology of him starting hip hop. And it's a lot. It's a lot. Even just getting where the word hip hop comes from, the only thing I can really pinpoint was that the word itself was developed and started being used the most in the 70s. So draw your own conclusions. Now, another theory and general consensus that a lot of people have is that rapping and the idea of one speaking or talking over a beat started back in the 30s and the 40s with Louis Armstrong. Now, a lot of you guys were like, Louis Armstrong, he didn't even make that.
I know. Some people call it corn. But right here is where the blues were born. Hear that music, blue, just the thing that you like to strut to on the floor. Hear the slide trombone and trumpet moan as you're coming through the door.
Louis Armstrong has a lot of songs, a lot of performances where he's literally just talking on a beat, where he's literally like, it just sounds like really old school rap on an old school beat. A lot of people don't take into account that what we're listening to today sounds nothing like what it came from and nothing like what it used to be. So with that being said, draw your conclusions down below. I need everybody watching right now, because some of y'all be hiding. Y'all be hiding behind your keyboard. I need everybody to comment down below. I don't care if you white, black, purple, pink, or green. Where do you think hip hop and rap started? Where do you think this started? Who started it? Why? And what theory do you resonate with the most? Now, there's numerous theories out there. Those are the top three that I've seen, but I'd love to hear your thoughts and opinions. Oh, wait. You want to see what my shirt says? You want? No justice, no peace. Y'all like it? Now, if you guys are not aware, I have predominantly been promoting black businesses this month. I've had a couple of subscribers send me their stuff, and I would promote it on this channel. Today's sponsor is Mac Clout. Go follow on Instagram, okay? Illustrations, commissions, digital artwork. Of course, aside from the artwork, we have attire. As you can see, the lovely shirt. Now, this isn't a large. This is, like, huge. I don't know why I keep buying myself in a large. Like, you know what? That's the thing. I like to cover my little booty sometimes when I'm in the house. Like, I got shorts on. I got shorts on. Don't play with me. But sometimes I like to cover my little booty or whatever. Like, so it's just so cute. Especially around the house, when I go to Dollar Tree, when I go to Marshall's, when I twerk by myself in the mirror. Listen, leave me alone. I do a lot of stuff. Don't act like y'all do that in your house. Listen, y'all gonna stop covering me. You will get it, okay? Even printouts. Look at these printouts, bro. The quality, I could never. Could you ever? I could never. So that's why I'm happy I have these, because now I don't gotta do it. Somebody else can do it in the quality. You would think that I paid big bang for this. You would think that, like, I got this from like an art museum or something. And just look, it resonates with us. Like, it looks like us, it's for us, it's by us, it's amazing, it's incredible. The artwork is so amazing, the quality is great. So even if you don't want a t-shirt, make sure you pick up some artwork. I promise you, you will not regret it. Everything you need is down in the description or in the pinned comment down below. Make sure we support our own, especially before we support everyone else. I know a lot of us are going through some trying times, so if you can't afford it, the least you can do is share it, and the energy you put onto the world will be bestowed back upon you. So make sure you check out Mac Clout down below. Now let's get back into the conversation of rap and hip hop. Now that I've told you guys the three leading theories, there of course are other theories, so I definitely urge you guys to leave those down below if you haven't yet, because boo child, there's a lot going on there. However, let's mainly talk about how detrimental it can or can't be. Now, I don't want to be a hypocrite, so I'm going to be as open and candid as possible, okay? And I'm also need y'all to comment again if you haven't, because I know there's some people that don't like to listen. Clearly, y'all hard-headed. Y'all deaf. Comment down below. Do you or do you not think that modern day hip hop and rap culture is affecting the black community in a negative way? I need your honest and open opinions, unbiased. I don't care if you listen to rap and hip hop, trap, whatever, or any subset. I wanna know, do you think it's detrimental or not? Now, usually I have a clear cut opinion about a lot of things, but I always play devil's advocate. I'll be like, I don't like this, I hate this, I don't like it, I will never like it, I don't agree with it, but then I'll be like, I understand why people would agree with this, I understand why this makes perfect sense, I understand people who think this way. In this case, I don't know where I stand. I like trap. I like hip hop, but I think hip hop is dying. I don't think it's dead yet, but it's dying. I feel like R&B is dead. I already talked about it in my unpopular opinions video. It all sounds like boring ass elevator music for the most part. Now that I think about it, and now that I'm saying it out loud, I really don't listen to as much trap and hip hop as I used to. I listen to Haitian music very much, like 90% of the time. But there's like a good 10% of the time I'm like, you know what, let me listen to some Pop Smoke, okay? Let me listen to some old 50 Cent, okay? Let me listen to some cancel Tory Lanez. Like, there's times where I sit there and I'm like, you know what? Let me put on some American music. Let me put on something that makes me remember my roots, okay? Makes me remember the hood again. But essentially, most of the time, I do listen to Haitian and Zouk and island music. So let me know, what do you guys listen to, okay? Because most of the time, I don't listen to it. And to be quite honest with you, a lot of times, I don't listen to it because a lot of it is just very meaningless at this point. I feel like back in the day, rap and hip hop was a form of expression. It was a lifestyle. It was people talking about their experiences and putting it to music, putting their experiences into words and being able to translate it on a beat to resonate with other people who may be going through the same thing or something similar. It was music by us and for us. Now, rap music and stuff has turned into like a whole heap of bullshit. Now it's just people rapping about big booty hoes, drugs, alcohol, shooting, killing, gangs, dropping out of school, just detrimental to our community and detrimental to everyone with a pulse. Okay, let's be real here. The whole rapping about killing, shooting, and all of that is just like really bad. Now, I'm not even gonna say that when I grew up, the rap was better in terms of the vulgarity of it, because clearly it wasn't. Like, let's be real here, okay, for my 90s babies.
Think you a gangster, but you never shot nothing. You think you a gangster, but you never nothing.
The music was just as bad. I do feel like it's definitely gotten worse, and I feel like maybe, not even maybe, a lot of the time back in the day, there's no way we understood half of the stuff we were saying. Cause I know damn well I didn't. It wasn't until I got older, I'm like, I was saying what? I said, Uchi Walla Walla, she do her dang thing. Oh nah, I thank God I wasn't doing my dang thing. But I do realize that there's a lot of kids, even back then and now, that internalize this stuff. And it is a problem. Like, to be honest, people should be watching their kids, and I believe people are adults. They should be able to make music about whatever they want to. But it's gotten to a point where it's just very excessive. That me as an adult, I can't listen to a lot of rap music. Like, I really can't. Like, certain songs, yeah, it's like, ooh, you talk about shooting and killing and ooh, like, this is sad. But the thing is, since I've been through it, since I've held a gun, I've been shot at, I've lost a lot of friends. Listen, we're not gonna get into all of that. since I've been through that, it's like, it doesn't get in my head to the point where I'm gonna pick up a gun and go kill something. It just doesn't. Like, it doesn't. Because I'm grown and I know what's right from wrong. With a lot of kids, their development is not there. And when there's not a parent or any type of guardian there to monitor or like actually pay attention to what these kids are consuming, it becomes really detrimental because these kids end up internalizing a lot of really bad thoughts and a lot of really bad behavior. You also have to talk about the normalization and the glorification of hood culture, unprotected sex, thotting. Okay, thotting. Like, it's really interesting because people excuse these behaviors all damn day, okay? They'll sit there and be like, oh, well, they're grown or people should be able to do what they want. I get it, but we need to understand that when we push the whole idea of do what you want, you need to also push the idea of there's consequences for doing what you want. You wanna sit here and promote thought culture? Okay, when you get pregnant, don't complain. When you get an STD, don't complain. You wanna sit here and normalize hood culture? Living in the hood is not great. This whole everybody want to act like they from the hood is annoying. Like, I've had people that are from out here and they try to act like they're so fucking hard because they from Hillside. Now, if you from New Jersey, you know where Hillside is, and you know damn well Hillside ain't nobody fucking hood. But a lot of motherfuckers from Hillside split up and down, they from the trenches just because they bought up with Newark and Elizabeth. No, y'all not the hood. Relax. Stay y'all asses over there. It's just always been fascinating to me how these people want so bad to have a struggle. They want so bad to act like they're from somewhere. And this is not even just people that are non-black. It's just people who grow up in those areas, period. They feel the need to try to act like, oh, well, I'm hard, I'm cool, I'm this, I'm that. And I feel like a lot of it does have to do with the culture, but most importantly, the music. Because a lot of the music basically glorifies the whole, this is how it is, this is how I was, this is how I am. And look, I made it, I came from the trenches. Look, I made it, I shot this, I did that, I popped this, I do that. A lot of this music perpetuates the idea that you live that life, or you used to live that life. And the real problem that I have with this is, if this was your life, I don't have a problem. But there's been numerous Okay, numerous rappers that have gotten outed for like lying about their lifestyles and music. A lot of these motherfuckers never came from the places they rap about. Never lived about half the shit they talk about. Like, what is the point? If you're really rapping about how you had to shoot, kill, rob, steal, honestly, I can't be mad at you because that's your experience. If we gotta be real here, a lot of this happened because of a lot of the disproportionate treatment that Black people have gotten forever. Okay, there's a lot of things that go into that. Of course, we have the whole theory, which most people hold true, which honestly I think is true. But again, still a theory. Let's be real. I gotta say alleged, you know, legal purposes of them putting drugs and guns in our neighborhoods. If you put drugs and guns in the neighborhood, what the hell do you expect people to do? I do believe that you should use discernment and not do it, because clearly no one's fucking forcing you to do it, especially when it comes to a point where you're a fucking adult. Like, you grown as hell. You a whole 38. So I was like, well, they put it in our neighborhoods. No, bitch. At that point, you make an excuse and you want to do it for yourself. Okay, you're like 38. You have your own mind. Okay, you're not 16. Get the read. So in that essence, if you're rapping about something that literally happened to you, I don't think it's a problem. We can't take people's experiences away from them. And I feel like anyone and everyone should be able to rap about their own experiences. And as vulgar and ridiculous as a lot of rap music is, to the point where I can't even freaking listen to it, I genuinely feel like if that's their experience, they should be able to rap about it. My problem is when they sit here and try to act like they're from somewhere or try to act like they done something that they never done, because at that point you're influencing kids to do something that you've never been through. So why even do it? Of course, we have the answer. The devil. Like, that fake phony wangsta shit, I've never liked. I don't like, okay? 50 Cent said it best. I know a lot of us don't like 50 Cent, but you get the point. If you've noticed, hip-hop and rap culture is by Black people, for Black people for the most part, right? Most of the time, it's talking about our experiences. Well, that's where it's starting. But let's be real here. It looks like it's by and for Black people, but a lot of these rappers don't write their own shit, and a lot of these rappers don't own their own music. A lot of these rappers don't own their own studio. They don't own the record label. They don't own anything. They're just a face. This is why a lot of times when you see these like one-hit wonders specifically, they sat here, they made millions of dollars, hit platinum multiple times, but then, you know, maybe 5 to 10 years later down the line, they're bankrupt. And you would sit here and be like, but you were so famous. You were so amazing. You were so popping. The thing that a lot of y'all need to understand, okay, and I need everyone to listen very, very closely. A lot of Black people that you see doing things don't own a damn thing. They may look rich, they may have millions of followers, but that doesn't mean they own a damn thing. If you are not writing your music, at the very least, you don't typically own it. And for the most part, especially back in the day specifically, they would take these rappers and they would put them in horrible deals. If you guys ever watched the TLC movie, you would know about this. Even I don't think Michael Jackson went through this too badly, but even at that, he ended up getting hoed. But the point I'm trying to get at is a lot of these Black artists, especially back in the day, were fucked over and they were put into really shitty record deals where they were basically worked like slaves to put out music and they barely got anything in return. Essentially, even though hip hop is literally Black faced, it's not on the back end. At the end of the day, there's very powerful non-Black people. I don't want to just say white, because it's not even just white people, okay? Let's just be real. It's any and everybody, okay? Puppeteering the hip-hop and rap game to be whatever it is that they want. And it's actually horrendous when you think about it. How did music that started off as experience, that started off as culture, that started off as expression, all of a sudden come to violence, killing, dying, and a whole bunch of negative shit? Now, at the end of the day, I do believe most Black people have lived through a lot of shit that they talk about. But it's gotten to a point that it's so extreme that it's like fucking serious. Like, we're really singing about like slipping pills in niggas' drinks or robbing niggas and killing bitches. This is what we're really rapping about. Like, this is a little extreme. Of course, okay, for those of you that's in church, I bring this back, okay? I had to really think about my childhood. I remember, I'll never forget, back in the day when I used to go to Baptist church specifically, they used to always be like, oh, don't listen to rap music, don't listen to hip hop, don't listen to none of that stuff, don't even listen to pop music. They used to be like, don't listen to any mainstream music, it's the devil, they're trying to take over your mind, they're trying to take over the world, they're trying to instill horrible things in you. And I used to be like, y'all extra, y'all doing too much, relax. Now that I think about it, oh my God. It's crazy to think about, but it's not that far-fetched, because as you guys can see, especially thinking of the fact that a lot of kids in Black homes don't have fathers, when they have especially a bunch of Black men telling them how to lead life and how to deal with problems, it does translate to real life. Instead of talking about your problems, instead of hashing things out and thinking about things and breathing, we kill a nigga, fuck a nigga, take a nigga bitch. We do all this extra shit, okay? Whole consensus of most rap music these days is handle your problems with conflict. So what do we see in the street? What do we see in our community? Handling problems with conflict. Women, we get heartbroken all the time. A lot of niggas ain't shit. Also, let's all take accountability here. A lot of us make horrible decisions and we ignore our gift of discernment. But what does the music say? Oh, just take his money. Oh, just sit on his face. Oh, just take what you want, use him. Oh, I don't need a ring, I'm a this, I'm a that. Oh, well, I don't cook and clean, I'm a this, I'm a that. Meanwhile, the dude's still cheating on you, the dude's gonna abuse you, the dude's abusing you, the dude's cheating, the dude is literally royal garbage. Dude got a whole heap of charges, and y'all sitting here accepting this just because a song told you to. That's ridiculous. It's insane how many adults that I know have their life mantras as music lyrics. It's actually wild. Because they'll be like, oh, blah, 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 said it in a song. Have y'all ever looked at the credits of a lot of these songs and realized that a lot of y'all rappers don't fucking make these songs? Have y'all ever looked into the backgrounds of a lot of these rappers and realize that a lot of these rappers don't live the shit that they sing? Now, why would they go along with this? Of course. Money! Let's be real. These people get multi-million dollar record deals. And most of the time, they're set after that. A lot of times with this money, instead of actually saving, investing, and starting something for their own selves, they sit there, they spend, they flex, they do all this extra shit. And then, next thing you know, blah, 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 bankrupt. It's ridiculous. It's a vicious cycle, and it's really horrible to see. Don't get me started on the quality. Jesus Christ, the quality of music has gone down so bad these days. And besides the lyrics, sometimes songs be sounding like they got recorded on a Nokia, man. Like, who made this, who produced this, and who let it out? Who let the dogs out? Who? You remember this song? But anyways, y'all get the point. Like, it just doesn't make any sense. It's not logical how bad the quality of music has gotten over the years. Not even just the lyrics, not even just the instrumental, just the whole overall quality. Like, everything is just royal garbage. Of course, there's some gems there. There's some rappers out there that are making really good headway, okay? We're not talking about those outliers. I appreciate those people. Because I know there's going to be people like,
oh, well, y'all listening to the wrong music. There's plenty of...
Shut the fuck up. They're not mainstream. They're still not mainstream. I don't care about who you listen to, who you don't listen. They're not mainstream. And there's a problem they're not mainstream. Thank you very much for listening to them. Okay? I listen to them sometimes too. Okay? I love me some J. Cole, some Kendrick Lamar. I listen to them sometimes. Okay? I do. Just as much as I listen to a lot of other artists sometimes. Let's be real. Like, I don't listen to this music as much as I used to. Growing up, that's all I listened to. But now it's like, it's dumb. So essentially, why is it that these people that are making uplifting music for the black community aren't as mainstream as like Drake or Rick Ross or anyone else that's like a heavy hitter in the mainstream game? Just why? It's just very, very interesting. And I'd love to know your thoughts and opinions down below. Personally, my opinion is I feel like anyone and everyone should be able to listen to what they want, but you need to be extremely mindful of what you're listening to, why you're listening to it, and if it affects you. Because you may sit here and be like, oh, I'm an adult, or I'm this and that, that shit don't affect me, I know right from wrong, I know what I shouldn't do. But at the end of the day, a lot of times, sometimes you're hearing this music, and it's not even just music, it's a lot of things. Sometimes you just come across certain things and you're like, oh, well, this doesn't affect me. This doesn't bother me. This shit didn't do anything to me. And then when you look back, it's like, oh my God, like I'm acting like this. I'm doing this. And this is something that I've been subconsciously taught to do. This is how I've been taught to handle my problems. This is how I've been taught to rectify stuff. And it's really, really toxic. So definitely something to think about. Make sure you guys comment down below. What do you think about everything I said in this video? Also, make sure you go purchase something from Mac Clout. Like I said, quality is impeccable. And of course, make sure you guys like, share, subscribe, do all that. And I'm gonna see y'all next time. Thank you.